you're like, ah. So we're going to start with some spinal breathing. Just balancing so you find a position that's most comfortable with your respect. You're feeling grounded. Hands up, chest out, breathe in. Breathe out, fold. Make sure your elbows and wrists touch. Breathe in. Breathe out, fold. Breathe in. Breathe out, fold. Breathe in. Breathe out. One last big in-breath, and release. Okay, roll your shoulders back. Give a nice good stretch. Change direction. Sometimes it feels weird when you change direction. And back again. And forward again. And kicking it. Shake out your arms, your arms at your side, big circles forward, forward and back.
Takes my mind a second.
And back. Okay, you want to drop your arms, shake your hands out of this. How are you feeling?
Good.
A little bit warmed up in the meridians. Okay, deep breath in. We're going to do another spinal breath, but when we get to the up breath, we're going to stay there. So arms up, breathing. Again. Let your lungs pause. And one last breath in. And breathe out. And drop your hands to the mat. And when you're ready, just straighten your knees as much as is comfortable. And then you can either hold onto your elbows or swing your hands behind your legs. Stretch and just grab hold of your wrists. We'll just rest here. So we're going to hang out here for about 2 minutes and just really stretch out that lower spine. Deep breath in. From the up breath, drop your hands to the mat and go into downward dog, put your feet behind you. You don't want to worry too much about the position of your feet or your legs. Just going to use your palms and push yourself back. Deep breath in. Breathe out. Another deep breath in. And on the out breath, I want you to bring your right leg to between your feet. Make sure your knee is directly above your ankle. And then we're going to transition into warrior one. So you can either use your core to push yourself up, depending how strong your core is. Or you can use your hands and just gently push yourself up.
Oh gosh.
How's that? Hands in front of your heart. It's easy. Find one spot on the wall in front of you and just focus on that spot. It'll help you keep your balance. If you can, bring your arms above your head and just slightly bend backwards as far as you can. If you can hold that for a minute.
I can try very hard.
Remember to breathe, pull in your belly, pull your belly button in right towards your spine, and it'll help you with your balance. And then just keep your eye on that spot on the wall. And then we can transition to warrior two. So you're going to twist to the side, bring your back foot, so as your toes face forward, there we go. Bring your arms out.
That's easier.
We can hold this for a minute. This actually doesn't look like it, but it's very good for strength building in your arms. Hold it for long enough, your arms will start shaking and you know you're building strength. Breathe in. On the out breath, lower your left hand, let it go along your left leg. Take your right hand up and over your head and look up to the sky. It should feel a really good stretch down your right side. Breath in, and now breath, come back to warrior two. Deep breath in, and now breath, transition back to warrior one, hands above your head. Bring it down, bring your hands down to the side of your feet. Deep breath in, and the out breath, back to downward dog. Give yourself a nice stretch. How's that feel? And then walk your legs in front of you. So you can either have your feet together or mat width apart. And then just going to go to dangling again. Just gently come up, hold on to your elbows. We're just going to hang out here for a minute. Deep breath in. On the out breath, drop your hands back into downward dog. Push it into the palm of those hands, stretch the back of your legs. Deep breath in and out. Breathe again. Breathe in. And on the out breath, bring your left foot forward this time. Forward. Make sure your knee is above your ankle. And when you are ready, you're going to transition into warrior one. Bring your hands in front of your chest, find your spot. My right side is definitely better at this than my left. Okay, breathe in. In the out breath, raise your hands. Let's see if we can hold this for a minute. Welcome to spring. I think your weather is playing ball today.
Yeah.
And then just gently lean back. Okay, deep breath in. Position to warrior two, take your hands out, turn to face your side, hips facing forward, and your toes pointing out. Breath in. On the out breath, drop your right hand on your right leg, lift hand up above your head and look up to the sky. You're feeling a really good stretch down your left side, no pain anywhere else. Breath in. And the out breath back to warrior two. Deep breath in. And the out breath back to warrior one. Deep breath in. And the out breath hands down. Deep breath in. On the out breath transition back to downward dog. Move the dog. Bouncing one knee at a time. Deep breath in. And the out breath position. Transition to plank. Let's see if we can hold this for 30 seconds. Pull your stomach in nice and tight, it'll help. And then rise against six pack. Breath in, and the out breath, lower yourself down to the ground, flatten your feet, and transition into Sphinx. So make sure your feet are nice and relaxed, your elbows are underneath your shoulders, touch your elbows with your hands, make sure they are width apart, hands in front, fingers splayed, you can either look through the head or just rest your neck. We're going to hold this for a nice long 4 minutes. To breathe, nice deep breaths in and out through your nose. If your mind begins to wander, bring it back to your breathing. take a deep breath in. On the out breath, you're going to push yourself up and transition into wide leg child's pose. Push yourself up. So slowly your body needs you to move. Push your big toes up together. Your knees on mat width apart. And then slowly walk yourself forward until you can bring your forehead to the mat. If the mat is too far, you can form a fist with your hands and then rest your forehead on your fist. You can hold this one for another 4 minutes. Remember to breathe nice and deep and try to focus on relaxing all of your muscles. You want to be as relaxed as possible in this position. Deep breath in. On the out breath, put your hands, slowly push yourself up. You want to swing your legs out in front of you. side as far as is comfortable. Bring the right foot to the inside of the left thigh. Turn to face the left leg. Put your hands on either side and then just fold over as far as is natural for you to go. And just relax completely. Make sure there's no tension in your neck and shoulders. You're going to breathe nice and deep into your belly. up to seated. Come back to center. When you're ready, the other side, take the right leg out as far as it's comfortable. Left foot on the inside of your right leg. Turn to face your right foot and simply fall forward. Just put your hands above your head. Let's see if that helps.
I think so. Normally, like my process of having like the cold and I get that itchy cough is when I'm getting better. Normally,
I think it should be pretty worse. Between your feet. So you're going to come up onto your knees and you're going to slowly slide back until you can put your hands onto the back of your feet. If that is too far for you, then just use your bolster and come to rest on your bolster as far as you want to. So it can be this high, it can be that high. You can put your bolster out into a comfortable position and then just let your knee drop. that's, yeah, you think it worked. And then switch your drop, and you're going to hold this one on for a minute.
Because I know it's a tough one to hold. I don't know if I can do it, but I'll try.
See if it's easier to take your bolster out a little bit further. And then do it like this. It's a slightly more gentle curve. Rachel gets you all the way, don't worry. So the important thing with this form of yoga is to bring the ground to you, and so you can bend all the way down to the ground, and not to force your body to do what it doesn't want to do. You're going to breathe deep. Shallow breathing means you're going to go into a panic mode. I don't want you to panic just yet. Take a deep breath in, slowly lower yourself to the ground on the out breath. That's a good stretch. These little blocks come very handy. Okay, swing your legs out in front of you again. You're going to do caterpillar pose. We're going to hold it for 4 minutes. So bend your knees and grab the bottom of your feet and walk your feet out until your legs are as straight as they are and you're comfortable. So even if your knees are up by your ears, it's fine. As long as you're comfortable and you're feeling the stretch in your lower back. Okay, then just drop your head. Take a deep breath. Relax all your muscles. And hold. hands out in front of you, especially if our bolster is within reach, which is going to be using the bolster now. Then I want you to slowly come lie down onto the mat. Now you do one final pose before Shavasana, and that's star pose, so lift your legs up. Put your bolster under your hips. Make sure that it's under your hips, not your back or your thighs. It must be under your hips. And you put the left leg out to the corner of the mat. Right leg out. Right arm out. Left arm out. Just make sure that you're nice and comfortable here. And it's, again, it's just under your hips and not your back. Okay? I'm just going to hang out here for 2 minutes. Breathe in. On the out breath, bring your arms down and your feet flat on the mat. Lift your hips, remove the bolster, and then just come down to lie to Shavasana. Let your feet fall naturally, your hands at your side, palms facing up. Make sure your shoulders are away from the ears. Take a deep breath in. Thank yourself for coming and doing yoga today and doing something for you, because you are important too. into a quick body scan. And as we focus on each part of our bodies, just focus on releasing any tension in the muscles there and just being as relaxed as possible. So much think about your toes and your feet. Ankles and your shins, your calves. Your knees and your thighs. Take a deep breath in. And on the out breath, release any tension left in your legs. Glutes and your hips. Your stomach and your lower back. Your upper back and your chest inside and out. Take a deep breath in. Release any tension still in your body and torso. Your fingers and your hands. Your wrists and forearms. Elbows and your upper arms. Deep breath in and out to release any tension in your shoulders and neck. Your face, feel your cheekbones and your lips, your forehead, your cheeks. Take a deep breath in and release any tension in your face, the back of your skull. Just breathe and relax for a moment. Deep breath in. Let it fill up your entire torso and belly. And breathe out. Come back to the room and wriggle your fingers and toes. Move your ankles and wrists. Move your head slightly from side to side. Deep breath in and out. And when you're ready, push yourself up into a seated position. Take as long as you need to. Inhale. Ready to start the day. Thank you for joining me. Rest your heart. Namaste. Happy being there.
Yes, I am. I was feeling so anxious this morning, like so overwhelmed. And this has just brought me like back down to reality, and just I feel so much better now.
It's all gonna be okay. Awesome.
Thank you. I'll see you tomorrow.
Same time.
Thank you so much. Have a good day.
Oh, you too.